हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सुपर फास्ट स्टडी एंड एक्सपेरिमेंट वेलकम्स यू। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट हाइड्रोलिक सिलेंडर फोर्स कैलकुलेशन, कंप्लीट कैलकुलेशन विथ एग्जांपल। इन दिस वीडियो वी अंडरस्टैंड व्हाइल यूजिंग अ हाइड्रोलिक सिलेंडर हाउ मच फोर्स इज प्रोड्यूस्ड। ऑल्सो वी अंडरस्टैंड द force calculation in a forward motion of a piston and backward motion of piston too. So let's start. Hydraulic cylinders are most commonly used in a industry in a various machines applications, and also it is widely used in automobile sectors. While using hydraulic cylinder, we can produce a large force with very small effort, and this is the advantage of the hydraulic cylinder. To calculate force developed by any hydraulic cylinder, we require two things. First is a cylinder diameter. With the help of this, we calculate the piston area and fluid pressure. In hydraulic cylinders, hydraulic fluid, hydraulic oil are used, and for force calculation we require the pressure of that fluid, and we can easily get the pressure of a fluid from pump, because in pump pressure is given. So let us start our calculation and formula. Now this is a formula of force calculation. Force is equal to pressure multiplied by area. Pressure is the pressure of the working fluid, means hydraulic oil, which is used in a cylinder, and area is the area of a piston which is used in a cylinder. Suppose the pressure of fluid is 150 kg per centimeter square. Now we calculate piston area by formula pi r square. Now suppose piston dia is 100 mm, means 10 centimeter, so radius is 5 centimeter. By formula pi r square, value of pi is 3.14, we get answer 78.5 centimeter square. The cross section area of a piston, means the area of piston, is 78.5 centimeter square. Now here we take pressure in a kg per centimeter square, so we calculate area in a centimeter square. Now we have both the values. Now apply formula, which is force is equal to pressure multiplied by area. Now pressure is 150 kg per centimeter square and area is 78.5 centimeter square. By multiplying this both, we get answer centimeter and centimeter become cancelled from each other. We get answer of 11,775 kg. While converting it in ton, we divide it by 1000 and 11.775 ton. Means a hydraulic cylinder having a diameter of 100 mm is capable to lift a load of 11.775 tons. Or we can say that it produces a force to lift that much amount of load. Now this calculation is for forward direction of a piston, means when a piston moves outside from cylinder. But what happens when a piston moves inside to the cylinder? When piston moves inside to the cylinder, here cross section area is reduced because some area is occupied by the piston rod. Suppose piston rod is having a diameter of a 40 mm, means 4 cm. So what happens here is area is reduced. So what we have to do? We calculate the total area. What is the total area? Total area is 78.5 cm, total area of a piston. Now area of a rod is 12.56, by if we calculate with the formula pi r square. So what we have to do, we are subtracting this area by piston area, by rod area, piston area by rod area, which gives an answer of 65.94 centimeter square. Now again we apply the formula, force is equal to pressure multiplied by area. Now pressure is 150 kg per centimeter square and here the area is 65.94. So we get answer of 9891 kg, means 9.89 ton. In a backward direction of a piston, it produces a force of which is equal to lift a load of 9.89 ton easily. Means in a same working pressure, if we increase the size of our cylinder, means if we increase the diameter of a cylinder, it will produce a large amount of force. And if we are using a smaller diameter cylinder, it will produce less force. Because force is directly proportional to pressure and area. So friends, I hope this video is helpful to you. If this video is even 1% helpful to you, please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.